What to fix up when selling a house. It's what we're talking about today, and we're starting right now. My name is Jennifer Canepoli. I sell residential real estate with Taylor Allen Properties in Destin, Florida. If this is your first time to my channel, go ahead and click that subscribe button. I do post every Wednesday about all things real estate in Destin, Florida, and I know you don't want to miss it. This is a series on getting a house ready to sell. Last week, we talked about what to do to the interior of your home. This week, we're going to talk about what to fix up when selling a house. Okay, so you've cleaned out your yard, you've planted some flowers, you've cleaned out your house, you've started packing, you're not done yet. What you need to do now is walk through the interior and the exterior of your home and assess any needed repairs. You might be thinking, my house needs so much work. And maybe it does, maybe it doesn't. But either way, keep watching this video so you can narrow in on the more important repairs to do when getting a house ready to sell. So it's very easy to just start with cleaning out your gutters and cleaning off your roof. If you don't have a blower, borrow one. Get up on the roof, clean off all debris and leaves. This is also incredibly helpful for the inspector who will eventually be inspecting your home once you've got it under contract for a full price offer because you have done the work to get your home market ready. Next, you are going to want to repair or replace any rusty or sagging downspouts and gutters. It just looks bad, especially when a buyer is walking up to a great house. This is gonna stick in their mind and they're instantly gonna start thinking, what is wrong with this house? Is it falling apart? You don't want that. While you are up on the roof, cleaning off the leaves and all the debris, take a look around and see if there are any needed repairs up there. You might need to replace some shingles, or maybe there are some torn shingles or fading shingles. Maybe the boots need to be repaired or replaced. Either way, these are all relatively easy fixes. And again, it's gonna deter waving that red flag that something could possibly be wrong with the roof or that it's in an old condition or something. Maybe you have lived in your home a long time and maybe you haven't. Either way, caulking of any kind gets old and tired eventually. So go around and check your windows, your showers, your tubs, your sinks. Please do not leave moldy, dirty, yellowing caulk around any surfaces. This is probably one of the easiest fixes you can do, and it will pay off big. While you are going through your home making the needed repairs, make sure to repair all of the non-working switches and outlets. Again, this is a red flag to buyers about your electrical issues with your home. And again, while you're doing that, make them all match. Make the switch plates match. Or if they're broken or chipped, just repair and replace that too. Another easy fix is, wait for it, replace burnt out light bulbs. Believe it or not, this does get overlooked and it does make a huge difference when the home is showing to buyers. Repair or replace any fixtures or toilets that need it. This is relatively inexpensive and it will keep the buyers from questioning the true quality of the home, and it just looks better. To me, to the inspector, and to the appraiser, the number one most important repair to make to your home is leaks. If you have a leak in your roof, fix it and make any needed repairs to the damage that it may have caused. If you have a leak under your kitchen sink, fix it and make sure that there are no stains and fix any damage that it may have created. If there is a leak in your bathroom sink or the shower head, fix it and repair any damage. This is probably the one repair that's needed that if you leave it and wait until you're already under contract and in the inspection period, it could definitely hold up your closing, because if an appraiser comes in and says, there is a leak or a possible leak, you have to get it checked by a plumber and you have to make the repairs that are needed, and it could hold up the closing due to having to have a re-inspect for that damage, leak, or whatever. So just do it before you put the house on the market. If you are set on listing your home for sale, selling quickly, and getting the best price for your market, put in the work, and do the needed repairs. Watch the rest of the series on house sell preparation to learn more about what you can do when getting a house ready to sell. Give me a thumbs up, share my video, subscribe to my channel.